online Messy Church Light Party. We're so glad you could join us this afternoon, and we hope that you're ready to celebrate Jesus being light of the world. We've got ready with our sparkles on this afternoon. Do you like them?
I love my sparkles.
Yeah, it looks brilliant, Messy Matilda. Well, why don't we get started with our light trail? So some of you might have been out and about on Chesham High Street looking for our light trail posters. Why don't we check in with Bert and see how he got on when he headed out to try and do the light trail.
Hello, Bert.
Oh, I wish you'd hurry up. When's my friend Harry coming? It's getting very dark out there. I don't like the dark. I'm really scared. Come on, Harry, hurry up.
Oh, Harry, it's just too dark. I can't go out now. I'm so scared.
With this cool light, we can go anywhere. Don't be afraid, Bert.
Well, Bert didn't want to go out in the dark, did he? It's a good job that Harry had his torch and his glow stick so that they could go and do the light trail. Well, we hope you enjoyed joining in with the light trail. Why don't we take a look at the answers and see if you managed to get all six?
All six?
All six. Let's take a look. Jesus said, I am the light of the world. John chapter 8, verse 12. Right, Messy Matilda, are you ready to get up and about moving now? Yes, let's hand over to Shirley for some light exercises.
Oh, yes!
Good afternoon, Messy Church, and it's me again, Shirley. Welcome to this special exercise routine that's all to do with light. I hope you have a great afternoon. Enjoy.
Well done. Five more. Three, two, one, and then stop. Have a bit of a breather. Good. Now you're going to do squats.
I'm blinded by your grace. I'm blinded by your grace.
Very good.
By your grace. I'm blinded by
your
grace.
Five more. Four. Three. Two. One. Have a breather.
Been broken.
Very good. Next time, you're going to do... what are you going to do?
Blinded.
High knees.
By your grace. You came and saved me, Lord.
Very good. Excellent. Kick those knees up.
Not worthy.
Very good. Five, four, three, two, one. Next thing is do your sit for the rest of 1 minute. Have a breather.
One time for the Lord.
Catch your breath. And then you're going to do heels to your bottom.
Freeze a T-Smith on the courts. One. Stay prayed up, then I
that's
get the
it, stay there,
yeah,
heels to your bottom,
but I'm God's son. But
keep
I'm
going,
now,
yeah,
God's
that's
son.
It, thumbs
not
up.
Real tall, look at what God did. On the main stage, running around topless.
Well done.
And, I tell him that
and then stop,
this is God's plan.
Have a little bit of a breather.
Like,
well
right
done.
Stop
and
you're
going to do that all
you
over again.
Not
so you're going
first.
To do Star Jump.
It's not by birth, but oh my God, what a God I serve.
Well done. Five, four, three, you there, two, one, and rest. Have a breather. Very good. Next, you're going to do squats again. Well done. Seven, five, four, three, two, one. Have a breather. Very good. Next, you're going to do high knees. Very good. That's it. That's it, honey. Five, four, three, two, and one. And stop. Have a breather. Very good. And next, you're going to do heels to your bottom. That's it. Nearly there. You're right, Clara. You're nearly there. You're doing a really good job. And five, four, three, two, one. Thumbs up. And Say hi, Missy Church.
Hi, Missy Church.
See you soon.
See you soon.
Bye.
Well, welcome to the Messy Church Light Party, a chance to celebrate the light and to think about Jesus, who said, "I am the light of the world." Some of you might remember we've been thinking about Jesus saying things about himself that start with, "I am." And in a moment, we're going to be thinking about what Jesus meant when he said, "I am the light of the world." But I think we've got time for a quick quiz. Up for a quick quiz? I hope so. Just a quick quiz about light. Are you ready? I'm always up for a good quiz. Here we go. Here's the first question. Most of the Earth's light comes from where? Does it come from light bulbs? Does it come from the sun? Does it come from the moon? Does it come from volcanoes? Any ideas? If you're stuck, perhaps ask somebody, maybe an adult, they might help you too. Most of the Earth's light comes from the sun. Hope you got that one right. Right, next question, question two. Light from the sun is used for giving us energy, giving us warmth, for seeing things, for helping things grow. Or maybe all those answers might be right. What do you think? Any ideas? Well, actually, all of those answers are right. The light from the sun gets used for lots of really important things, keeping us alive even. Okay, question three. Which can travel fastest or faster? Is it sound or is it light? Any ideas? What travels faster, light or sound? The answer is, any ideas? It's light. In fact, if you ever see lightning flash in a storm, you see the light first, but sometimes you have to wait for a bit for the sound to catch up because it doesn't run quite as fast as light runs. So light travels quick. Question four. If you could run the same speed that light runs, in 1 second, how many times could you run round the entire world? That's how fast light can go. Is it one time? Is it two times? Is it four times? Or is it eight times? Any ideas? If you could run as fast as light, in 1 second, how many times could you run round the world? The answer is almost eight times. Wow, that must be pretty quick. Okay, question five. You may know that some animals glow. You might have heard of glowworms, for example, worms that glow. But what about people? Do people glow? True or false? Any ideas? The answer is, we do glow. We give off light, but it's so small, it's so faint that our eyes can't see it. Wow, there you go. Something you've learned today. Last question. Okay, imagine you are in a room that is totally dark. If you turn the light on, who will win? The light or the dark? In a dark room, you turn on the light. Who wins? Does the dark win or does the light win? The answer is, of course, the light wins, because the light is greater and stronger than the dark. And when you turn the light on, the dark has to go. Well, Jesus said, "I am the light of the world." I guess that sounds like a bit of a weird thing to say. Does it mean that in a dark room, Jesus would have glowed? Does it mean you didn't need candles or a light or a torch when Jesus was around? Well, no, the Bible says that Jesus came and he looked just like an ordinary person. He didn't stand out because he was bright. But actually, he did stand out because he was different. And he was the light. You see, the fact is, we live in a dark world. And we haven't got to look very far to see lots of things that are wrong with the world. Things get spoiled, people get sick, and some die. Our beautiful creation is hurt and damaged and broken. People hate and they fight. Children go hungry. It really is a dark world. And the Bible says that dark that we see all around us, well, it's also in us too, if we're honest. It's something that's inside us. Perhaps even today we've said unkind or cross words or horrible things have come out of our mouths. Perhaps we've acted selfishly or been greedy or said something we know wasn't true. Yes, the world is dark, and the Bible says it's dark because actually there's dark in us too. When we ignore God and push him out of our lives, when we choose not to listen to him, the Bible says we'll always end up living in the dark, and the world will always be a dark place. But the good news is that Jesus came into the world to be the light. There was nothing wrong or dark about Jesus. He loved people. He was never selfish. He never said hurtful words or lied or cheated or took stuff that wasn't his or was greedy. No, his life shone beautifully because he really was the light of the world. Well, you might think that people were happy for Jesus to come in as the light of the world. But here's the strange thing. People hated the light. I wonder why that was. Just a while back, I was sweeping in the kitchen, and I thought I'd done a good job sweeping up all the mess. But when I turned on the bright lights, you know, suddenly I realised the floor wasn't quite as clean as I thought. You see, the light showed up all the dirt and the mess. And when Jesus came into the world as the light, that beautiful bright light, well, he showed up all our mess, all the stuff that's wrong with the world and in our lives too. People don't like being shown that they're wrong. They prefer to cover up and hide the mess. And so what did people do to Jesus? Did they thank him for being the light? No. They tried to put the light out by killing Jesus. But here's the amazing thing. When Jesus died, he was taking all the darkness in us, getting rid of our darkness and being punished for all the dark and all the wrong things that we do so we could be forgiven and become like Jesus and live in the light. Well, when Jesus died, it looked like the darkness had won. It looked like the dark had put out the light, had defeated the light forever. But that's not the end of the story. You see, 3 days after Jesus died, he rose. He came back to life again and defeated the darkness forever. You see, the light really is more powerful than the dark. And the Bible says that Jesus is, and he still is, the light of the world. And if we ask him, he can give us his light so that we can walk in the light in a new life. As I finish, let me explain just very quickly 3 reasons why it's great to know Jesus, who is the light of the world. It's great having Jesus shine his light into our darkness. Because he does that not to hurt us, but actually to change us, to help us reflect his light as he chases out our darkness. And I can say, it's a brilliant thing to be living in the light, not having to hide or cover stuff up, because we know Jesus has forgiven us and shined his light to make us light too. And then second, following Jesus, who is the light of the world, is really great if we want to know the right direction to go. Just last week, we were in doing a walk, and we walked through a dark cave, a dark tunnel. and I couldn't see my feet. I couldn't even see a hand in front of me. It was so, so dark. But one of my children had a torch. And if he hadn't had that torch, we would have been lost and confused. And Jesus is the light to show us and direct us in the right way. So when we listen to him, when we stay close to him, he will take us through, even through dark times, and eventually bring us home to his home, a wonderful place where there is no darkness that we can enjoy forever. And then finally, when I was in this tunnel and it was very dark, I think I would have been a bit scared if it weren't for that light. And some of us perhaps are afraid of the dark sometimes. It can be a bit scary, can't it? That's why some of us like to have lights near us when we go to sleep. But as we go through life as friends of Jesus, staying close to him, he is the light. And life isn't half as scary when we know that he's with us. He'll never leave us. And he'll always be the light. Jesus said, "I am the light of the world." That's great news, isn't it? Something to celebrate. Much better to celebrate the light today than to celebrate the dark. Jesus said, "I am the light of the world." I think some time now to go over and do something food-wise. We're going to make some food. So I'm going to hand over to Nigel and Evelyn and friends. So over to them.
Auntie, Auntie, what's going on? It's all dark. Where are you, Auntie? What's going on?
Oh, it's all right, Rocky. I'm here.
Oh, thank
you. Even though you can't see me, I'm still here. Let me put the light on.
Okay.
Oh, that's better. Oh, were you alarmed?
Yes.
I just fell asleep for a moment. My goodness, it's the dark. Oh. Makes me go to sleep. But it's all right. Everything's fine. And because we're thinking about light, because we're thinking about Jesus being the light, we're going to make some candle biscuits. We're going to decorate. I found these lovely long shortbread finger biscuits, larger ones.
But Auntie, they're long. I thought you said they were shortbread.
Very observant, very clever, Rocky. Yes, they are still called shortbread, although they are the long biscuits. These are the larger ones. And I should just show you. There we go. If you can see children and grown-ups, we've got some white icing nearly to the top, and I've decorated with some little silver balls to like the wax, and I found some of these nice little sweetie things to be the flame. So that's what we're going to do.
Oh, that looks lovely, Auntie. Can I take one home with me?
Yes, Esmeralda, of course you can. So to start with, to make the icing, I've got 100 grams of sifted icing sugar, and I'm going to mix that with 1, 2, 3 teaspoons of warm water. Now, I did this earlier, and it worked perfectly, so let's hope it's now going to just come to the right texture. If it doesn't, I can always add a little more water.
Mm.
That's these teaspoons vary. Let me put a little bit more in.
Yes. 4.
You just have to gauge it. There we go. That's nice. Nice and stiff. Ooh, no, we need a bit more. Right, here we go.
You knew how to do this.
Well, it worked perfectly with 3 last time.
Yeah.
There we go.
That's what they all say.
I'll put that out of the way for now. So, with your teaspoon, we've both got a teaspoon, can you two do that together like you've done before?
Yes.
You've got your biscuit.
Here we are. Let's probably hold it.
Yeah, you get your spoon full of icing.
Oh, it's going to go over her hair.
And you go along like that, near the top, not right to the top, children, because we want to have a space for the flame. And you sort of spread it out like that.
Oh, mine's looking great.
Oh, that's fun. It doesn't have to be too neat, as long as it looks a bit like a candle.
Yes, thank you.
There we are. That's wonderful. Now, shall we put some little silver balls on it? Depends what you've got in the cupboard. You could use sprinkles, anything really.
That's good.
But I thought these look rather nice on it.
Oh, yeah.
So I'm going to put some down the side.
Oh, it's real bad.
Yeah. You put some of those to look a little bit like the wax winding down the candles. So it looks quite pretty like that, doesn't it? There we go.
All right. Oh, I'm going to pour them on.
You're going to pour them on? Oh gosh.
It's lots of wax.
And I found some silver, edible silver spray that we used for Christmas star biscuits last year. Messy church, if you were here. I've got to spray some of that on. It's rather fun.
You sure it's not a deodorant?
Yeah, you may not have this, but not to worry. Use whatever you've got.
Oh, that looks nice.
Now, flames. Let's tip some. These nice little flame things.
Oh, can
they're little, like little triangle things, aren't they?
Look quite
I think the yellow and the orange and the red. But you need to have a tiny bit of icing from the back of your spoon. Have I done with my spoon? Oh, it's in here. So I'll use a little bit of that on here. And perhaps an orange one. Red.
Well, this looks nice. They look just like flames.
Yes, they do, don't they?
Go on, Esmeralda, you have a go.
Thank you.
There we go. That's fun, isn't it?
Oh, yes.
So,
ooh.
Is that it then?
Excellent. But, Auntie, I don't want to draw your attention to anything, but there's no chocolate.
Oh dear, of course. Rocky's rather fond of chocolate, isn't he?
Yes.
Well, actually, I did find a little treat at the back of the cupboard, some white chocolate hearts. They won't show up that much, but there you go.
Oh, lovely.
And what I thought would be rather nice if we put it on the flame of the candle.
Ooh,
and that can just show how much we love the light that God gives us through Jesus. There you go.
What?
Super.
God bless and see you next time. Lots of love. Bye.
Bye. Bye.
Well, wasn't that fantastic to hear that Jesus is the light of the world? So why don't we sing about Jesus being light of the world? Messy Matilda, are you ready to do some actions?
Yes, let's go!
Okay, let's sing Light, Light, Light.
The world is searching for an answer, a ray of hope in a hopeless world. Who can we turn to? Where is our rescue? There is someone, he's the answer, he's the light, and he'll light the way. His name is Jesus, and he came to save us. He is the light, 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 light of the world, and he shines, shines, shines all over the earth, shining bright, bright, bright. He is the light of the world. He is the light, 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 light of the world, and he shines, shines, shines all over the earth, shining bright, bright, bright. He is the light of the world. The world is searching for an answer, a ray of hope in a hopeless world. Who can we turn to? Where is our rescue? There is someone, he's the answer, he's the light, and he'll light the way. His name is Jesus, and he came to save us. He is the light, 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 light of the world, and he shines, shines, shines all over the earth, shining bright, bright, bright. He is the light. Light, light, light of the world, and he shines, shines, shines all
Well, I think it's time that we did some crafts together. So hopefully you've managed to pick up an activity bag ready with your crafts inside there. So let's go off and see how to make a stained glass window and a pumpkin paper plate.
Oh, I can't wait.
Yeah, let's check it out.
Behind me is a stained glass window. There you'll see a picture of Jesus on the cross. At his feet, Mary, his mother, and there's also St. John, one of his friends, the disciples. Now you're going to have an opportunity to make your own stained glass window. In your packs you'll find all the materials that you need. And just like the window behind me, as the light shines through the window, it tells the story, reminding us that Jesus is the light of the world.
Oh, Harry, I'm so excited. Let's open the pack. Which envelope is it?
This one today.
Oh, the smaller one. Right, and what's inside, Harry?
Let's look.
So get your tissue paper and spread them out around the holes. Show them the cut glass, Harry. You might see one of these in a church window. Got lots of colours on, and that's what we're going to make, a stained glass window. You might have seen it at St. John's Church that you saw earlier. Okay, so you'll spread out your bits of tissue paper and make sure you don't put all the same colours, Harry. That's right, you do it. And then what do we need, Harry? How are we going to stick it on?
We get our glue.
And where are we going to put our glue, Harry?
We're going to glue lightly, all little bits all around the sides.
Okay, right. Shall we do that then? Shall we put a bit... And come on, I want to get the tissue on. Quick. Way! Well done, Harry. That took ages though, didn't it? But you've done a really good job. So why are you snipping now?
Because I have to snip off all the edges that have been hanging off.
All right. Be careful, everybody. Don't cut your fingers. And how are we going to hang it, Harry?
We have to get the little thread and put it through the hole at the top.
Oh, that's a good idea. And then where are we going to hang it?
On the window.
But it's dark outside, Harry. How are we going to light it up?
So we're going to put a light behind it so it'll shine.
Oh, so it'll look really cool from the road.
Yeah.
We can see Jesus shining like a light of the world. Yeah, that'll be really cool. We'll go and do that in the window now, Harry. Bye, everybody.
Bye.
What's in a big envelope, Harry?
All we're doing is doing things about pumpkins. There's a prayer, and today we're making a pumpkin
plate. And it's going to hang, is it?
Yes.
With dangly bits.
Yeah.
And what else are we putting on the plate?
We're putting two crosses for the eyes, one triangle for the nose, and a smile.
And what are those green things?
They're big leaves to go on top and a stalk.
Okay. Do we need glue?
Yes.
And what about those tassely things?
They are for the...
Roots.
And
they'll blow in the wind.
Yeah.
Good. Right, we better get sticking then.
To the leaves at the top. So at the end, I expect you to do the the little stringy bits at the back last. I'll show you when it's done. Here's the finished pumpkin.
Wow, that looks amazing, Harry. And what's this little bit of paper with this prayer on?
It's a prayer that shows that you Christians are like pumpkins.
How can we be like pumpkins? I'm not big round and orange. Well, are they from the Bible, those verses?
Well, this prayer will show you why. God picks you from the patch and brings you in. Then washes all the dirt off you. He opens you up and scoops out all the yucky stuff. He removes the seeds of doubt, hate, greed. Then he carves you a new smiling face and he puts his lights inside you to shine for all the world to see.
Oh, thank you, Harry. That's amazing. All those words come from the God's word, the Bible. Thank you. Shall we stick it on the back?
Yes.
Wow, brilliant.
Hello, prayer warriors. It's me, your local friendly neighbourhood prayer ninja. Actually, I'm on a very secret mission. It's very late. It's very dark. I'm somewhere in London. Actually, I shouldn't even be here. And actually, I shouldn't even have this light on. So why don't we check in the morning when it's light? And I can talk to you properly. Be stealthy. Uta! Uta! That's better. I can see you and you can see me. I'm enjoying a cup of Mongolian breakfast tea. Stuff of ninjas. Isn't it so much better? When there's light, you can see me, I can see you, and we can see everything that's going on around. To be honest, when I was doing that special mission last night, I was a little bit scared. Even ninjas are allowed to be scared. But there was one thing that helped me overcome that fear. And do you know what it is? Well, actually, it's a little thing in the Bible that says that Jesus is the light of the world. So when I got a bit scared, I just imagined Jesus as the light of the world, filling my life with light and pushing away all that scary stuff. Great thing is, when you're feeling a bit scared, you can also pray to Jesus. Remember, he's the light of the world, and he can fill your life with light and push away all that scary stuff. Should we pray now? You ready? Okay, let's center our cause. Heavenly Father, we thank you that Jesus is the light of the world. We thank you that you told him all about us in your Bible. We thank you that as the light of the world, he pushes out all the scary things in our lives. And we look forward to turning to him, especially in those scary moments. And we ask this in your name, Jesus. Amen. This is your friendly neighbourhood ninja checking out.
Well, we hope you've had a fantastic afternoon celebrating Jesus as light of the world. Messy Matilda, have you had a good time?
Oh, I've had a great time.
Brilliant. Well, we do hope you'll join us for our next Messy Church, which is on the 14th of November. So do look out for details of that and we hope you'll join in then. But we hope you have a fantastic rest of your weekend. See you for now.
Bye!